You ever sit around a table or go out for dinner with somebody and they start talking about relationships they're having with their kids or with their partners or with a friend or with a coworker, and you say to yourself, wow, if that was me, I know what I would do. You ever say that to yourself when somebody's talking to you about the relationship problem? And on any level, friendship or marriage, and you say, you know, I know what I would do. And it always surprises me how much that people are willing to put up with in their lives to keep the peace or to think that they're helping the situation. I talk a lot about in these videos about empowering yourself, about uplifting yourself out of the negativity of life. And sometimes that takes a lot of courage. It really does. How much courage would it take for you to stop these toxic relationships? And I don't know why you're doing them. Maybe you're doing them because you think it's the right thing to do. Maybe you're doing it because you're Christian, or you feel guilty, or you just don't know how to get out of it. You know, I've had relationships like I'll give you a few examples, like a person who always told me, I'm too busy to talk to you, Terry G. I would leave messages, I would go and see them. I do all these things to nurture that relationship, and I wouldn't get anything back from it. And I talked to my friend about it, what was going on in my life with this relationship, and he said to me, Terry, just chop it off. Just chop it off. You don't have to make a big scene. You don't have to write a letter or say anything. You can just behave differently and withdraw from those relationships. You know, it's like going out in the garden and watering the weeds, right? The toxic relationships in our lives are like weeds. We don't have to cut people off, but we can engineer that relationship that is more suitable for us. Like another person I have in my life, or I had in my life anyways, the bloodsucker, emotional bloodsuckers. The one that always calls you up, talks your ear off about themselves all the time, all their woes in life. They're not willing to do anything in their lives, but you're there, they're there bending your ear, telling you all about their difficulties, and you might even lend them money. I know I have. But the time and the place when you need help, when you need support, they're not there for you. They're not. Toxic relationship written all over it. Chop, chop, chop. Chop, chop, chop. And I know that we're going to have relationships in our lives that are toxic, that are not good for us. You know, at work, things like that, that are not healthy for us. And we don't have to let those in, I get that. But I'm talking about the ones we choose to let in. Why do we let those in? Why? What is it that drives us to keep these relationships going? Like I said at the beginning, I talk about empowerment and enriching your life. Hang around people who add to your life. I know it's not perfect all the time. I know people go through things. But generally speaking, the people I have in my life are for me. They help me. They support me in my time in need. They really do. And we do it back and forth. A really healthy relationship. I love what Robert Williams said. I sooner be alone than hang around with people who make me feel alone. It takes a lot of courage to walk away from toxic relationships on any level. It really does. But I'm telling you, if you have relationships in your life that are bringing you down, you might want to take a look at them, analyze them. What am I getting from this? Why am I doing this? What's making me want to be with these people? And you might think, you might come to a conclusion like I did, there is nothing in it for me. Without me participating in that relationship, there is no relationship. This is toxic, this is unhealthy for me. Hasta la vista, chop, chop, chop. So take a look at relationships around you that are bringing you down. And why are you letting these relationships in? Why are you constantly letting these relationships into your life, and you're wondering why your life is full of bull and bringing you down? Empower yourself. Stand up and say, I will not take it. I am better than this. Move forward. The right people will be attracted to you without you even doing anything. The friends I have in my life now are like me. They move forward. They're positive people, they're get up and go people, they're supportive, they're great people in my life. I have a few people in my life that still bring me down, but I've engineered those relationships that they don't affect me like they used to. I'm not involved. I'm supportive, but I'm not involved in them. It's kind of off the cuff. I just parked on the side of the road and I decided to make a video. It's the first one I've done in a long time, just off the cuff. So if you like my video, like I say, subscribe to my channel, leave a comment if you can, and remember, look after yourself because it shows, and have a great day, and I'll see you next time. Thanks for stopping by. Bye.